My name is Artyom Kossolapov, and I'm here in the Department of Nuclear Science and Engineering. I'm studying primarily boiling heat transfer. I started my bachelor in nuclear engineering back in Russia, in St. Petersburg. And there's actually where I also got into research. That's where I actually started to learn experimental work, and that part of my life actually that what got me excited about experiments. It's always fascinating when you build something and you can actually look how it happens in the real life compared to what you see in a textbook. I mostly focus on the phenomenon called critical heat flux. This is a kind of phenomena that prevents our nuclear reactors to operate at enormously high powers. We have this hard limit on the power which caused by the phenomena called critical heat flux. It's the limit in the heat that we can remove by boiling, because at some point when you generate more and more bubbles, they kind of tend to clump together and form a stable vapor film on top of the boiling surface, which insulates it. And if you start to pump some power through the insulator, it has nowhere to go, and so eventually your surface gets overheated. And this is something we always try to avoid inside the nuclear reactor, and to be honest, never get even close to this limit. But if there is a way to actually know better when this limit is happening, or even a way to increase it, then we can operate our reactors at higher power. I'm trying to build a facility which will mimic exactly the conditions inside the reactor. This presents its own challenge, because inside the reactor we have 15.5 megapascals of pressure. This is like 155 times more than the atmospheric pressure you breathe and walk in. But the pressure alone is not that hard. It's hard to combine it with temperature, because you also need to go above 300 degrees C. And so in those conditions, it's really difficult to get any meaningful measurements. And what we're trying to do is actually look inside, like have a windows and use other advanced techniques like infrared thermometry to actually see what's going on, how boiling occurs at those conditions. Currently, both in US and in around the world, we have hundreds of nuclear reactors, and most of them are what we call light water reactors, which mean they practically boil water inside the core. And if there is even several percentage of power increase that we can achieve in those reactors, it will be a tremendous boost to overall power production. Nuclear is one of the best ways of producing electricity without emitting greenhouse gases. So this is what we are trying to achieve.